Just wanted to raise a question, since we know that there is the notion of folks being asymptomatic, or so if we're requiring or looking at, you know, at expanding sports or anything, if there would be any thought given to testing for athletes to participate.
I think it goes back to this notion of us having, the way the colleges do, sort of that robust kind of testing that the school district would do. We're in a bit of a different situation. Terry, do you want to talk about that in terms of?
Yes, if I understand correctly, in order to do that for athletes, as they do for college sports and professional sports, you'd have to do it periodically, either every practice or every, you know, 2 or 3 days. In that case, I think you would have to contract with a company to do that and, you know, make it mandatory. And So I don't, that would probably change the way we've looked at high school sports. I'm not aware of high school teams currently that do that in Pennsylvania, but that might be something, you know, that could be looked at.
I mean, therein lies the absence of a robust and fast testing program that's universally available to people so that you can, you know, one of the things about testing is if you take a test, and it takes 3 days to get the test back, and you don't quarantine yourself for the 3 days, you've just made it very difficult to do the kind of tracing that you need to do. So we've heard instances where somebody says, well, I took the test, but I didn't get it back yet, so I'm still walking around. Well, that's not helpful. You really need to stay, correct, Terry?
Well, there are some rapid tests available, but that you can get within 45 minutes.
I'm talking about the 3-day test.
Right.
Yeah.
So the accuracy, though, is in question for a lot of them, so you'd have to be careful looking at the type you select.